Okay, so this video is supposed to be short, but let's be honest here, I'm probably gonna take a very long time to film this, but this is the second time I'm filming this video because the first one was too long, and this one's also probably gonna be too long. But I have a couple of disclaimers to make. This is a rant video. Yes, I will be ranting about NYU. Yes, I'll be ranting about relationships and people here and also just in my life. If you are mentioned in this video, it's with no ill will, so please like don't like come for me or whatever. Like, I'm sorry, but this is just like about my life or whatever. And also, if you like don't agree with the things I'm saying, I'm gonna be making a lot of comments about classes and stuff like that. If you don't agree, that's fine, but this is my opinion and I have a right to it. I'm entitled to it and I'm not like, an entitled person. But I just feel the need to rant, and also the reason I'm refilming this video is because I felt like while I liked my last video, it wasn't as positive as I would like it, so I'm gonna try to make it more positive, and I'm also gonna try to make it shorter. Yeah, so welcome to Hello, it's me, it's second semester Marie, and the thing about second semester is when stuff gets real, no more coddling, no more babysitting by your professors. And the other thing about second semester that I found is that, well, first semester was a lot more conceptual, it was a lot more about just like ideas and reading, which I'm perfectly straight, like I'm so good at this. Stuff. This semester has been a lot about creating and making and doing, and as someone who didn't grow up super artsy, that's already been super hard, right? Because like while I'm in an art school, yes, I spent most of my time in academia, that's what I was good at, and so recently that's the first thing that's been coming up, is just a lot of like comparison, a lot of like, oh, am I meant to be here, because like I didn't really do this. And so that literally has been like the first part of like just me having like low-key breakdowns and like low-key comparison, like rages and rants and things like that. My whole last video that I filmed that I'm not gonna publish was just kind of me ranting about that, but like that was already like a lot coming into this semester. And then this semester I'm doing an internship, so my schedule is completely different than last semester. Also, the thing about a new semester is that like while last semester you're getting like settled in, like you're getting oriented, like you're trying to figure out your whereabouts, like you kind of know what you know here in second semester. You kind of know that you just don't know things, but you have a lot more friends and you have a lot more people that you talk to. And so I've been trying to balance that because like, while last semester I was like a mess, like socially, like low key, like just not vibing at all. Like I had a lot of time, but this semester I have a lot less time because I have more classes and I also have an internship and then I also have like a social life. So that's been like the idea. And especially February, for some reason, February was just a month. February was just the month for everything to happen. And that's why I'm coming at the end of February, a rant. Trying to keep this short, but you know what I mean? I have lots to say. So February starts and I'm already like, that's when my internship starts and I'm already like, okay, whatever, we're figuring this out. I ended up, I was in this play and I ended up dropping it because my schedule was literally so packed. Like I had no time to eat. And when I did eat, like it was like during my rehearsals and it was like crazy, it was insane. I was feeling so depressed and so down. So I ended up dropping that. And then I also had like a pitch thing I was doing for a grant and I haven't heard back from that. So like that was fun. And then I also had a other thing that I submitted for and I got rejected. So I mean, I'm telling you all this not to complain, but just to be like, this is like the life, I guess, of me here at NYU Tisch. Like I'm trying to get certain projects out there and some things are moving fast, but some things aren't moving slow. I've been submitting myself for auditions and stuff and it just like, has not, like the way that like I did it back home, which was like super easy and like fun and like it was like super, it's like a lot different. New York is like a completely different scenario, it's a completely different place. But, like every time someone asks me like, hey Marie, like how's your acting career going, and I'm like I mean not really, but like low-key yeah, because like just it's just not been going, it's been at a halt, it's been at a standstill. And, like the play was the only thing that I was really doing and I dropped that. And there are a lot of things that I've been perfect for, but I just haven't been able to do that. So that's been fun, right? So second semester, I'm like, okay, I ended up like just like low-key planning on just dropping relationships as well because I was just like, I'm not really into it. I'm not really into apps. And I just found that like a lot of the guys at NYU, okay, put it frankly, like the guys I was meeting first semester were not, it's not a great group of guys. And I was just also in this mindset where I was like attracting a lot of like negativity in my mind. So like, I was just not into it. I was just not into it. And I was like, okay, I'm good. I've talked to some cool guys, but at the same time, it's not working for me. I'm done with the apps. I don't want to do apps anymore, whatever, right? But before I like completely delete my apps, I get on them one more time and I end up meeting this guy. And long story short, he's like, low-key super sweet and super nice, and in a weird way, like something that I had manifested, like something that like I hadn't ever had before in a relationship, and also hadn't ever had before like in a partner or just even in like a friend for the most part. And that was this guy. And so I was like, wow, like obviously like low-key the universe sent him, like low-key, like I don't know if you believe in that shit, like I don't know if you do, but like I do. And it was just like so many things about him like matched up with like what I had always wanted. I was like, why not, right? Why not? Because it's February, right? So we kind of start talking, but the other thing is he doesn't live here. He lives 2 hours away, and that was just like something I just wasn't expecting. Like, the other thing about me is like, I'm not someone who's great at keeping in touch long distance. I never have been. You can ask any of my friends. I'm so bad at text. And I went to an online high school, and so many of my friends like dated online at my online high school, and I never did. Not a single time. I had crushes on guys, I had guys I was into, but I never dated any of them. The only relationship I had where I dated was in person, and I had known him for years. So this was something that was completely different for me. And so while that's happening, while I'm spending my weekends with him, and I'm spending like my week just working, I just felt like my inner artist, like just like what the heck, because like my YouTube channel, I had the chance to do like one live, and my acting just not going on, and I just literally wasn't feeling connected to myself. And even freaking better, my classes. So there's my teachers, and I'm doing this coding class, and I again just, first of all, just doing art regularly is not something I'm super used to. I didn't have access to fancy art schools and like all these art backgrounds. Like I was like the only artist low-key in my family for a long time. Like artist, when I say artist, like an artsy person. But welcome to my coding class, where I have to code and do art. And I know I'm in an art school, so I'm not complaining, but it was just like, what the heck? And there was a moment where I literally ended up crying to my teacher, or like, well, crying while my teacher was talking, because he was basically just disappointed in where I had been. And someone who's a people pleaser, that's just hard to hear. It's hard to hear. And I didn't end up making an excuse. I didn't tell him about my internship or all the shit I had going on. I was just like, what do I need to do to make it better? And so there were times that he was just critiquing me in class. And this is the thing, I'm not soft. I'm fine with criticism. I had my martial art instructor for 10 years, and he was like an Abby Lee Miller. I'm cool with criticism, but I need criticism that's constructive. I need you to give me something to do, and I need it to be something that was already in my possibility of doing. Because if you're just like, make this art look better, So that was already just super frustrating for me, and I've just been feeling super comparing myself with my other companions, because I were doing a lot of solo art, and I'm really starting to see who I am as an artist. And so that's all happening, and it kind of just kind of comes to like a culmination at like last week, the last 2 weeks, where like basically I got food poisoning, and I started to get really really behind and starting to face writer's block. And then that's super fun, and then we ended up ending the relationship for a lot of different reasons. I'm not gonna really say why, but we just did. And so that's always super fun, because you know, no matter what, like I'm genuinely fine with that relationship ending. Like I am a pretty independent person. I don't really need to be in a relationship, or it was like something that's like a coincidence. Like you're not gonna meet a person like this. It's hard to be like, wow, is the problem me? And like low-key, I'm not perfect. I know I'm not perfect, and like being in a relationship, like quote unquote, like shows me how I'm not perfect, because I'm seeing the ways that I'm not perfect, and that's not easy as someone who's a perfectionist. And then when it ends, it's very much like, was this the right decision? Was this the right thing? Could I have changed this? Should I have done something different? And all of those self-doubts kind of begin to come up. So that pretty much all happened on one single day, and then just like just being behind in my classes and just things like that happening, feeling different, feeling excluded. I literally was like last week, like I, those 3 days I just slept for 12 hours. Like I don't do that. Like I am someone who's very much like get up, do my thing. Like, I don't get up early, but I get up and I do my thing and I get my homework done, but literally just been sleeping. So I just kind of wanted to come on here and talk about that, because like how do you deal with like writer's block? Because like literally that's what I've been dealing. How do you deal with like relationships, the negative thoughts and comparison? Because as someone who struggles with those things so immensely, like I deal with it every single day, and I'll probably deal with it every single day for the rest of my life. But there are some things that I've learned, and I just wanted to talk about that here. But I also want y'all to check out my book, How I Became a Teen Actor. I actually have a chapter on self-confidence and self-image and how to love yourself, and I also go really really in depth in it. I put a lot of my love into it. So if you guys want to check that out, be sure, it's on amazon.com as How I Became a Teen Actor, or on my website, marietagbell.com, but yeah, check that out. But basically, some of the things that I do to kind of deal, I guess, the first thing that I always do is every single morning that I wake up, I journal. And I'm not gonna say journal, it's not some like cute, fluffy, like, oh my God, today I talked to Tim. Like, no, today, like, I literally, like, fuck this shit. Like, fuck, I hate being here. Like, I hate da-da-da. Like, every single negative thought that you have when you wake up, that's what I put on my journal. Every single morning for about 3 pages, it's just negative stuff. It's all over the place. It's random. It's anything that you can think of for 3 pages. But mainly for me, it's about getting that negativity out there, because a lot of negativity isn't just, like, that you have in your mind. Isn't that, like, you actually believe it? It just is, like, circling your mind. You just need to put it down somewhere. And so when you put it down somewhere and you look at it on a page, it's like, oh, like, why would I think that? Like, that's not true. Like, you begin to, like, dismiss some things and then get to the heart of, like, what you're really feeling. And from then on, then if I have time, I'll do affirmations or whatever. But it's really, really important for me to, like, write down, okay, this happened and I felt so embarrassed and so ashamed and I was so anxious and da 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 da, like, everything you wake up with in the morning. That helps me just really clear my head for the morning. And then, of course, maybe I'll do, like, a meditation, or maybe I'll do some affirmations, or I'll look in the mirror or whatever. But, like, it's so important for me to do that every single morning. And it also just helps me, like, boost my creativity, like, overall, because all those negative things I'm thinking about my creativity, I'm putting it there. The other thing that I do is I try to imagine my inner artist. And my inner artist is really just someone who's like a child. It's like baby me. Me when I was 5. Me when I was 8. Me when I was 12 and just wanted to be loved and respected and appreciated for her artwork. Like, if I said to my baby self, like, oh my God, you stupid idiot, why the heck would you ever write something like that? Like, that would hurt her feelings. Like, what the heck? That's literally the stuff that we say to each other every single day. And so I try to, like, think, if I'm thinking something negative, I'm like, imagine saying that to, like, a 5-year-old. Like, would you say that to a 5-year-old? But, like, no, but, like, that's your inner artist. And that's why feeling writer's block, because your brain is scared to, like, write. It's scared because you're so mean to it. And so that's not something you should be mean to yourself about. But again, it's something to think about. Like, how can I be nicer to myself? How can I let myself come out and be nurturing and da 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 da. And the last thing that I would say has been really helpful for me is really trying to take things step by step. I am someone who needs to plan. I need to know things. I need to have everything locked down and squiggled and just put in a tiny little container so I can think about it and understand it and pick it apart. And literally, my goal for the last 2 weeks has been just let it be. Like, it doesn't matter. Like, it really doesn't. And of course, we're scared. Like, you're physically scared of, what if this person doesn't like me, or what if this teacher doesn't like me, or whatever, whatever, which is totally fine. But, like, in the grand scheme of things, it genuinely doesn't matter. And you have to, like, I have to remind myself that the universe literally always takes care of me. And so I need to trust the universe. And so that's what I try to do, is, like, take things up myself. Okay, so the morning, I'm not going to think about all the things I have to do. I'll just be like, I have to get up, I have to brush my teeth, I have to do this, I have to do that. And I try to do that because there's so much going on in my life right now. Like, you don't even understand. Like, it's insane. Like, I think about the things that I accomplish every single day and I'm like, how the heck did I, like, go from class to that, to this, to that, to talking to all these new people? And it's a new experience. It's crazy. College is literally insane, and it's in the middle of a pandemic. So give yourself a break. I'm trying to give myself a break, and that's what I'm trying to do. Like, remember, like, be proud of myself. Like, yeah, you go, girl. Like, what you mean? Like, what you mean you're talking down on yourself? Because, like, girl, you look beautiful, you look fly, you look gorgeous, and also, like, you just did da 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 da, and you need to be proud of yourself with that too. And it can be hard, which is why, like, I say write the negative stuff down. Like, if you're feeling negative, like, write it down. Be like, I hate this person. Like, I literally wish they were, like, whatever you're thinking, whatever you're feeling, like, write it down. Because sometimes all your brain wants is just, like, that part of you that's, like, negative. It just wants to be heard. And once you hear it out, then you can be like, okay, well, we're not gonna really, like, listen to you, but we listen to you, okay? And then we're gonna move on and do this other thing. So that's what I've been trying to do, and it's been helping me. Obviously, I'm not perfect at it. Like, literally, I have so much stuff that I need to do right now. I'm low-key procrastinating it because I wanted to film this video, but, like, it's fine. It's fine. But, like, it's just be nice to yourself. Like, literally, that's what I think. And, like, it can be hard to be nice to ourselves because it's like, oh, well, I can see all my failures and da-da-da-da. And, like, I do see my failures, and so, like, low-key, like, I write them down. I'm like, shit, like, you failed at da-da-da-da-da-da. Like, I'll make a whole list. And then I'm like, if I said that to a 5-year-old, like, how would she feel? She would hate that. So why am I saying that to myself right now? Because that's why I can't create. That's why I can't make art right now. And just really just think about the universe and how much, like, you are here because the universe took care of you. Like, everything that's happened in your life has been because the universe is, like, looking out for you and shit. So it'll do it again. It can do it again. Like, you don't need to be worried. Like, it's got you. So yeah, that's a little bit of my rant for the day. I have so much more to say about this stuff. Like, low-key, like, I have so much to say about, like, elitism at NYU, racism at NYU, sexism at NYU. But I'm not gonna get into that right now. But, like, those things are things that pop up every single day for me. Those things are things that pop up every single day for my friends. And, you know, just also the whole creative shebang. Like, who am I as an artist? Why am I here? What am I meant to create? And like, do I deserve to be here? But like, you know what I mean? One step at a time. So yeah, I hope this video was fun for you guys. If you guys like it, be sure to comment. Tell me your thoughts. Are you guys going through stuff right now? I don't know if you're in college or not, but like, low-key, this is applicable to every single person, whether or not you're in college. Like, if you're just at home, dealing with high school stuff, whatever. If you guys want me to do more stuff with, like, my relationships at college and, like, who I've dated and, like, what the stories are with that, like, I can tell y'all. I mean, I don't really want to, but I can. And if you guys want to know, if you want me to start posting more of, like, my arts and stuff, like, the work I'm doing, like, let me know, too, because I'll start posting that stuff, too. Okay, so thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to leave a like and a comment, and I will see you guys in my next video. Ciao!